Legislation, some resolutions. For example, a bill calling on the League of Arab States to step up efforts to stop genocide in Darfur. The vote was 425-1. You were the one. A bill calling on Vietnam to release political prisoners. 425-1. You were the one. Condemning the Robert Mugabe violence against Zimbabwe citizens. 421-1. You were the one. Awarding a gold medal to Rosa Parks. We could go on. Why? Tell us, explain why you so often have been the sole voice in the U.S. House of Representatives on what everybody else supports and what to so many people would seem like a no-brainer.
Right. No, I think maybe I'm only the only strict constitutionalist because I look at that from the Constitution. It's not that I'm against what they're proposing, but some of those resolutions, just interference, unnecessary. Carry that to the next step of that resolution between, condemning the Turks about Armenia. Just think of the chaos that created. Getting ourselves involved in some event 100 years ago, it makes no sense at all. We should deal with our problems here, with our defense, and not pretending that we know what's best. So it's a principle that I defend. I don't think I have the authority. It's meddling where we shouldn't, and it usually leads to trouble. Of course, the Armenian vote was much more troublesome, and look at the chaos it's caused between Turkey and the Kurds.
Congressman, I can understand your principled stance on the foreign policy-related issues, but what would be unconstitutional about giving the gold medal to Rosa Parks, a civil rights activist and leader that all of us are quite familiar with?
Well, that wasn't easy for me because I think she's a real hero because I believe in civil disobedience and I believe peaceful changes come about that way. But I was dealing with the money. Why should I tax you to give her a medal? I went to my fellow members of Congress and I said, I'll be glad to give her a medal. Let's each put in $100 and I'll put in $100 and we could pay for it. But to do good by taking money from the people, that is not a precise authorization in the Constitution. So the principle is that you don't have this right to do it, but to say something good and to to honor people like that would be fine, but we ought to do it with our own money, not with your money.
Congressman Ron Paul has become a phenomenon. Congressman, thanks very much for joining us. We'll see you out on the campaign trail.
Thank you very much.
Politics is a tough business. It's rough, too. Democrats are saying...